Hello and welcome to Barry McGuigan's World Championship Boxing. Not Barry McGuigan's, but Barry McGuigan. I'm fairly sure that's how that name is pronounced. Which is a very early boxing game for the Commodore 64, made by Sportswear. And it's actually surprisingly advanced, yet at the same time a bit simplistic. It is half management, half simulation, and half action. That's three halves for you. It's a very advanced game, by the way. You can build, I was about to say, create a boxer, setting up different parameters, and you can then choose whether you want to be a new professional or contender. A new pro will start at the bottom of the ranking list, and contenders will start at rank 10. As you can see, there are the stats, attitude, stamina, and so forth, and then you go and choose an opponent. The game will automatically suggest the highest ranked available opponent, but in many cases you want to get as many fights under the belt as possible so you can spend more time training. As you select your opponent, you get a chance to get to see your opponent's stats, and you also get to see how many weeks to the next match, because the amount of weeks you have available is important for your training schedule. The different elements you can choose to train, light back, heavy back, spar time, weights, and road works will affect various stats. Something like weights, of course, is strength, and road works is stamina. And once you have set up your training schedule thing, it is a fight time. We are controlling the box on the left, and if you look at the top of the screen, you can see endurance for both boxes. If that endurance goes down to 1 and you get hit, you are flattened out. Depending on your boxer's stamina, might actually be able to recover, but you do not control the boxer's movement, you control the fighting moves. And you have quite a few advanced punches, actually. You have jabs, you have head straights, body straights, body jabs, head jabs, crosses, uppercuts, and all sorts of things you would half expect from a boxing game. Your endurance, though, it is of course depending on how often you get hit, but it's also depending on how many punches you whiff. You don't necessarily want to just spam hit or try to hit your opponent, because you will run out of endurance, and once your endurance is down, you just need to get hit and you go down like a sack of potatoes. It's around display, by the way. Of course, the judges will score the different boxes depending on amount of hits versus amount of punches sent out. How active the boxer has been, all that stuff that boxing referees will take note of. And of course, the state of the audience. Are they bored? Are they ecstatic? Are they somewhere in between? And then of course there was stats for your remaining endurance, strength, and so on. Because of course as a boxing match goes on, your boxer and your opponent for that matter will get more and more tired and will start losing strength and endurance, or stamina. The stamina and endurance, or stamina even, and endurance of course are tied together. A boxer with a high stamina has more endurance and is more likely to recover endurance, more endurance between rounds. But that's basically it. There are certain criteria for amount number of hits in succession, depending on the boxer you are fighting. You can be strong against headshots, but weak against body shots, and strong against body shots, but weak against headshots. By saying headshots and body shots, of course, I mean punches, but whatever. Same thing, but different. Once you have finished the bout, whether you win or lose, if you win, you gain rank, if you lose, you lose rank. You get a chance to go on to the next opponent. And of course, the problem is, if you use the tactic of going through the lowest rank opponent, at some point you will have fewer weeks to train. The games are actually mindful of the fact that if you were to fight each individual boxer and get 10 weeks for each training session, you would be able to build up a boxer that was quite powerful by the time you reached the chance to get a shot at the title fight. I actually think I haven't tested it because that would require a lot more play time than I was necessarily prepared to give this game. I would assume it roughly evens out. I just personally like to punch my way through the competition. But of course, just because someone is a lower rank doesn't necessarily mean that the opponent is easier than an opponent that is higher ranked. You can run into opponents that's got nearly twice your endurance, despite the fact that they are a lower rank than someone you can easily go in and flatten. I suppose that's the way it works in real boxing as well, that the different ranking is. For instance, a very technical boxer may be able to avoid and dodge the opponent's barrage of punches and land a few good punches themselves and gain a lot of points and win by points instead of necessarily knockouts. Fights are set to 12 rounds, but I can testify that you are very, very unlikely to go the full 12 rounds unless you are your opponent and you are just standing there with your guards up. But that doesn't necessarily make for the most exciting game, so it is very common to go in and just fire off all your punches and see your endurance rattling down and get hit once and go down and not coming up again. Yeah. So, let's talk about the more technical aspects of this game. The graphics, I find the graphics quite enchanting, endearing in some way. You can definitely see that the boxers are boxers and they are big, strong lads, and the ring looks remotely like a boxing ring. The audience is not necessarily shown, but details. It's because of the blinding light or something, you can't see them. They're there, trust me, they are. Sounds okay, I suppose. I mean, it's limited how much you can expect from a game of this age, but I do really like the music or the jingles, tunes of this game. It's very distinct. I only need to hear a chord or whatever you call it in order to recognize the music for this game instantly. I'm not saying that's not the case for other music pieces as well, but there's definitely some where you need to hear a few notes before you pick up on what it is, but the music and jingles in this game are very, very unique and very distinctively, for me at least, remembered as belonging to this game. So, the fight we are currently fighting, we've had a knockdown on each side, and the outcome is going to be interesting, because you can probably see that my box is running out of steam. But just because we are getting tired doesn't mean we can't win the fight. I'm trying to cross his little face, but that's the one thing I would say about this game, is that sometimes it looks like your box is in range for certain punch types and they still won't connect. But, I mean, considering its age, considering the fact that it's partially management, very lightly, partially a simulation, very lightly as well, and partially an action game, it's just somewhere in between, I would say, somewhere in between very lightly and very action orientated. The whole package is actually quite enjoyable. Many years ago, I had to sit down and took the time required in order to work my way up to the rankings and take a few beatdowns and eventually challenge for the title and winning. And yes, your boxer will start punching faster and start hitting harder. You would expect as you get more and more training. But it is not within the scope of this video to show the full progression, because that is something that's quite extensive. One thing to bear in mind, of course, is the game will remember your boxer, so you can, when you start a game, you can get a boxer that you created, but of course, if you switch off the computer, that boxer's lost, so if you boot up the game again, you would have to start from scratch. But by and large, and I have to admit, I do find this game bizarrely enjoyable. There's something very enchanting about it. There's something very comfy about it. I suppose as comfortable as could be to get punched in your face, but you know what I mean. On that note, I'm going to say thanks for watching. Take care. See you in the next one. Bye bye for now.